Welcome to Business Line's State of the Economy podcast, where you'll find insight, analysis, and the story behind the numbers.
Hi, listeners. Welcome to Business Line's State of the Economy podcast. In this episode, we will look at basmati rice. Basmati rice exports have increased over the past couple of years. Since the 2021-22 fiscal, shipments of the fragrant rice have increased by over 30% in volume and 60% in value. Still, there is a lot of ground to cover and prospects to increase exports are higher. How is the basmati paddy crop this year? How are the prices? What have we to look forward to? What can the government do to help drive exports up? To tell us about these and more, we have Mr. Mayank Garg, Director of Aroma AAT Basmati Rice with us. Welcome to Business Science State of the Economy podcast on agriculture, sir. Sir, to start with, we would want to know how the basmati crop is shaping up this year.
Hi, Subramani. One thing that thank you so much for inviting me on this podcast. About your question, basmati crop this year is shaping up very good till now. The crop is really, really healthy. We are actually experiencing an increase in the production of the crop from last year of the basmati rice.
Sir, but what we hear are that the prices are low. So how are the prices? And, you know, they are lower than last year. So will it help increase exports?
Yeah, about the prices, yes, it is pretty low from the last year. Last year, the crop of 1509 basmati rice opened at a price of approximately 3500 per quintal. So this time, the prices are pretty low. And the crop of 1509, it's opening up at a price of 2600, 2700. The healthy crop is what we are talking about. And the prices of the crop vary about the moisture and the quality, etc. So this year, the prices are low as compared to the last year. And there's a major difference. We cannot say that there's a slight difference, but there's a major difference in the prices. And about this prices, I'll say, will it help in increase in export? Yes, it will help in the increase of export. Actually, on this front, I'll say that last year the importers were pretty afraid of the prices because the prices opened up way too high. So they actually were really afraid that if the prices will go down in the upcoming months or the upcoming year. But currently, if the prices are low, then the export will boom in the paddy season, the kharif season only. So the advance bookings will take place. And the exporters will plan their schedule accordingly. The last year, exporters could not plan their schedule because of the low demand from the importers in the kharif season itself. But this year, yes, we can say that we can plan our export and we'll get much better orders than last year.
Sir, what are your views on the minimum export price that the center has fixed for basmati rice?
My view on minimum export price is fairly, they have put up at price because earlier they have put up a price of $1,200 per metric ton for the export of basmati rice. But the prices at that moment were very, very high because that was the end of the paddy season. And during the end, the prices usually soar up. But and then the Rice Export Association, they negotiated with the government to lower it down to $950. So it's pretty fine and it's pretty good. So in the export of basmati rice, the exporters will not experience any difficulty and they are very comfortable with $950 price. So it's not and it's important is what I feel to put up an MEP so that we can restrict the non-basmati export. That's the purpose of government to put on the MEP on the basmati rice. So that will solve the purpose and we'll be able to export basmati and we'll be able to restrict the export of non-basmati rice. And we are actually coping up with the purpose of the government and the scheme is very effective is what I'll say.
Do you think that the government should be more proactive in the issue of getting, you know, exclusive marketing rights for basmati in foreign countries, especially the EU and the US? What I mean is the GI tag.
Yeah, the government should actively play a role in getting the exclusive marketing rights for basmati. Earlier, there was a dispute between India and Pakistan, and the Pakistan was on the lead for the expo, for the GI tag for basmati. But the government should be more proactive, because what we are experiencing, a trend of using the basmati rice name by EU clients and EU producers, though the rice is not actually basmati. And in the US, I have also seen that there are some companies who are using the name of basmati rice, but the rice is not basmati. So the government should play, and it's high time that they should play a more proactive role in getting right for basmati rice. Otherwise, it will be a problem for the industry, and it will be a problem for the consumers as well. The identification of the true basmatis could really be very difficult on that front.
Sir, in which countries do you think that we have scope to improve our market share in basmati rice?
See, there are, in the terms of food industry, the taste of every consumer is different. And there are some countries in which there is no export of market, no export of basmati rice. And there are some countries there with, where there are very huge export of basmati rice. So, countries like Australia and the USA and Europe, European countries, and more of this, we can say Russia, we have a major portion of market that is left for India. So there's a huge growth opportunity for the basmati rice exporters exclusively, not the non-basmati rice exporters, but I'm referring to here. So in these countries, the share of basmati rice would increase to up to 10 to 15% year on year. If we, like if the exporters, they work hard and get more clients over in these countries and spread the aroma of basmati rice across the globe. And there are some countries like Japan and Vietnam, and Vietnam is a major exporter as well. So they, but they are not producing basmati; they are just producing non-basmati rice. So if we try to like taste them, the basmati, the taste of basmati, if we make them try to taste the basmati, we'll be able to capture that market as well, because the basmati rice, the Indian basmati rice, it's actually like termed as the best basmati rice across the globe in 2022 itself. So we can capture that share as well. So the market growth opportunity is more.
So what happened to the efforts that were made to promote basmati rice in China, sir?
In China, see, the China are the largest producer of rice. I'll not say basmati rice, but rice. And the Chinese consumer, they prefer eating their own rice itself. Right? So they do not eat basmati rice. They eat small rice, which is a bit sticky. Basmati rice is not that sticky. So the choices of consumer in China are not inclined towards the basmati rice, but they are inclined towards their own domestic production. Exporters are now currently trying to get into the Chinese market as well with their basmati rice, and they are getting a little response from the Chinese market. Not that much response that is expected of the China market, but a little response.
Should the industry look at tapping the domestic opportunities more?
See, in rice is a staple product, and it is a need of every household at the moment. And the market and the domestic market is cutthroat market. The prices in the domestic market are cutthroat. And I'll say that there are two models in the domestic front. One is loose basmati rice, which some local kiryana stores or some wholesale market they sell. And another one is the branded product market. So the market of branded products, we can say there are the major two or three leaders, which is Daawat, which are India Gate, which are Kohinoor, and others are on the same level. And on the loose market, it's a huge stake. So I'll see for other brands, for the emerging brands like Double AAT Basmati Rice and other brands in their own specific area, they can capture a huge market share with in terms of quality, in terms of serving the best product and the pure product. So the opportunity for these producers of basmati rice in the domestic front is very, very high.
So thank you very much for your insightful views. We are grateful for all these views. We hope our listeners would have benefited from this. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Subramani, for this wonderful session.
Thank you very much for your enlightening views, sir. Thank you all for listening in, listeners. Until we catch up next time. Bye.